outside of SMART or even inside of SMART, okay? So you have five features here.
So I'm on the board, how do I go outside of SMART?
All right, so I'm gonna open, so I'm gonna use my Snippy tool, okay?
The camera.
The camera, I tapped on the camera. Y'all see the camera? Let me open it back up again, okay? So right underneath here, you see this button here on your toolbar. It looks like a little camera. If you don't see it, go to your gear over here on the far right. And then search under actions and find your camera, and you're just gonna drag it up to the toolbar. But I think by default, the camera does show there, okay? All right, so how do I go outside, okay? I have my little camera bar. I'm just gonna minimize SMART. I'm at my desktop, okay? So if I wanna go out here to Google, I still have my camera right here, okay? So the difference between the Snippy tool with Windows 10 and the camera feature is one, the camera is always gonna take whatever you snip and throw it back into SMART, okay? But the camera feature here gives you four options where the Snippy tool only gives you one or two options, right? So this first circle here for camera says, okay, you tell me what you wanna snip. So if I just want to grab this, it grabs a picture of it and it says, okay, do you want to send it to Smart Notebook or do you want to do something else with it? Okay, obviously I'm going to take it to Smart. So I'm going to put it on Smart. Put it on the page that I was actually working on, like that. Okay, so that's one option of it, okay? I'm going to add a new page here just so I can keep it off. So that is one option. This option here is it will capture my window. Okay? I tap that. You see how whatever's on my window it captures. And then it asks me the same thing. I'm going to put it in a Smart Notebook file. There it is. Okay? Now, what I can do with that, I like doing that, is it puts it in big, but then because it's an image, I then have the ability to resize it to whatever size I want just by dragging. Okay? So let me minimize this again. That grabs a window. This one, actually tap the window to capture it. So I'll tap here, it captures the same thing. Okay? But if I wanted to, yeah, it is kind of loud. Okay, so it grabbed the exact same thing here, okay? But if I wanted to, I could do this. I could minimize this, say capture this. It actually captured my desktop, okay? So what if you were doing, y'all use learning.com, right? Okay. What if you need to capture something inside learning.com? You go sign into learning.com, you can open it up, you can capture that. Now, remember, it's just an image. Yes, sir?
I'm trying to, I was actually using the Snippy tool. I'm trying
to get a box.
We heard.
I'm trying to actually box in something specific. And, like, the one to the very right, the one that had, like, the aqua shape.
Yes.
You're able to do that. However, how do you box in something specific?
Okay, so, it's going to be your first one. So let me go back here, let me get my camera. Okay, so if you want to do a complete rectangle, like you draw what you want, I use the first one, okay? The last one is kind of a free form.
Yeah.
It's kind of abstract, and you really got to play with it. So if I did the abstract one, like if I was just trying to get this little scuba diver here, I'd have to kind of, you see how it kind of, it's like, and see, I'm gonna bring it in.
Yeah.
So it's like you have to start. You have a starting point, and then you bring it around, and then it grabs it. So that one's probably the most difficult one. I primarily just use that first one, because then I just drop off the moment I want. Okay? So that is your camera. And then it brings it all in. So, the other nice thing about it is now these are all objects. Okay? And how many of you have ever used PowerPoint? I mean, Photoshop. Okay? So Photoshop puts things in layers, right? So think of, how many of you have been teaching long enough that you had an overhead? I got some lots. Okay? Or maybe when you were in that classroom as a student, your teacher had an overhead. Oh, yay! Remember how she had all those sheets of paper? And she'd lay them down, she'd put them down. She had, some of them were really fancy, she had the roller. Okay, so SMART, as you're building lessons, think of every object that you put in as one of those sheets of paper, okay? And it lays them on top of one another. So the first one you do is going to be at the bottom. The last one you bring in is always going to be at the top, okay? So as I snipped all these, as I went through each one, it was creating my sheets of paper. Okay? So here's my sheets of paper, right? So the last thing I brought in was this scuba diver, right? If I'm looking at this, and this is my sample, this is my scuba diver. Okay? My next one is my window of my desktop. That's this second sheet of paper sitting here. My next one is going to be this one. Okay? That's this sheet of paper. Right here. Okay? So they all sit on top of one another. So what my point to that is as you begin to move them, you may have to move images over so you can reach them. Okay? Like if I'm trying to move this guy, but I can't get to him because this guy's on top. So I gotta move him over, okay? And then this guy's gotta move over. Then I can just, do you see how I'm just pinching? And I'm just, or I expand and I can make it bigger, okay? If I tap on an object, that blue box around it, I call them marching ants, okay? So I have marching ants. Then I also have a green circle, and I have a gray circle, okay? So how many of you have SMART open right now? Okay? We're gonna simulate something here, because I want you to do this on your computer, okay? So everybody turn around, open up SMART, okay? Does everybody see your camera?
Yes.
Everybody see your camera?
Yes.
If you see your camera, I'd like for you to tap on it. And when you tap on it, it's going to give you this little dialog box right there, correct? All right, everybody got it? Okay. With that, I want you to minimize SMART so you have your desktop and you have that little floating toolbar. Okay? So minimize SMART notebook. Everybody know how to minimize? Don't close out of the application, but just minimize it so it shows up down here at the bottom. Okay? All right. Now.
Okay, I'm going to you.
How many of you have something on your desktop like icons? Kind of like I do. Okay? All right. What I'd like for you to do is I'd like for you to tap on this very first circle. Okay? Then your desktop kind of gets a little hazy. I want you to draw a rectangle box around a couple of your icons like I've done here, okay? So you're going to take your mouse or your trackpad and you're going to start at the top. You're going to move from left to right and then go straight down, okay? Yes, I will. Okay, so I have SMART notebook open. The camera button, when you press it, it opens up this, okay? then I'm gonna minimize my smart notebook. So I'm gonna tap on my minimize the application. Okay? Then I want you to tap on the very first option within the camera, first circle on the left. Okay? Then you're gonna draw a rectangle around what some of your desktop icons. So I'm gonna grab these two columns. So I'm gonna tap right in front of my first icon, press and hold, and I'm gonna draw a box around what I want. Okay? Then I'm gonna put it into my current page. Everybody okay with that? Who didn't get it? Design something, you want to make it look nice, or if you're having kids put pieces together like a puzzle, you can rotate the images in and then the kids have to rotate it to get them back together. Okay? Alright. So,
when you're creating your lessons, is it more efficient to do it on your computer or on the smartboard?
It's more efficient to do it on the computer. Because it's easier because you have a mouse.
Okay.
And you're comfortable building lessons. You can build them here. It does take a little bit longer. Alright? So build them on the computer. So here I have an image. So we know what this does, we know what this does. How many of you tapped on this little button? Okay. I like to call that guy, it's called a drop-down box, that's a technical term. I call it my BFF, okay? Because my BFF, I always go to my BFF when I need to do something, okay? So, by tapping on that, I can get a lot of different options or actions that could happen, okay? I can clone it. So real quickly, I can clone it. I can make two, okay? So I'll move this guy over here, okay? I can cut, copy, paste. I can delete, okay? How many of you know what the infinite cloner or what infinite means? How many of you ever created an activity where you had to have, like, the same image, like, 20 times, over and over and over again, and then you had to sit them on top of one another to make it look like there was really one, and then as a kid dragged it off, okay? So with SMART, they have something called the infinite cloner, so I'm going to tap on that. My BFF then becomes the little infinity sign. Symbol, okay? So now I can just create as many things that I want, okay? It's really good for counting. It's good for when kids are trying to put things in, trying to have multiple objects in, one object in multiple places. It's like a control copy, but you just set it, and you don't have to control copy all the time. So that's your infinite symbol. So then I'm going to delete them all. Okay. So anytime you see that infinite, that means that someone has cloned it. Infinite. Okay. Set image transparency. Okay. How many of you have ever gotten an image off the internet? And you put it on a slide or put it in a Word document, and your Word document or your slide has a colored background and has that white image around it. Y'all never seen that before? So the set picture transparency will actually remove it. Now, I don't have any, but it would show up in purple, and then I could just tap where I want it to go away. Let's see if I can make that happen. Yeah, so I just set my image transparency to get rid of the blue water and just show my icons. If I say okay, come on. And look. You like that? So it took out the background of it. Alright, so that's kind of nice if you want to remove just the background of it. Okay? So that is my infinite guy. Okay, I'm going to turn off my infinite cloner. I have a mask. What the mask does is it actually allows you to hide things that you don't want kids to see right away. Okay, you see how it's. So I hid it, it's still there. But I just hid part of my image. Okay?
You can only do, I guess, square mask or a rectangular mask?
Yeah, you can, you can't do a circle. It's either a square, rectangle, or another one. Yeah. So you can only hide certain areas, okay? And then to unmask it, you have to go back. You see how it's hidden? Then I tapped on it, went to my BFF, and I say unmask. And unmask will bring it all back to life. Okay? All right. This next feature that I'm going to talk about is called lock. Lock is very important when you build your lessons, okay? What locking does is that it gives you to lock an object in place so it cannot be moved, okay? You also can lock it, but you can allow it to move vertically, okay, up and down. You have the other one allow horizontal, so it locks it, but you can move it left and right, okay? Allow move, and then allow move and rotate, okay? So I'm gonna go back, and I'm gonna show you why those are important. I'm gonna go all the way back. Okay, I'm just gonna use this example.
Come on.
All right, I'm gonna use this example right here. This is just a slide where we put a table in and we're actually comparing Shakespeare's theater to just going to the movies, okay? So we have a lot of different things going on here. And I'm actually going to zoom into that. Okay, I'm gonna zoom it to 100% so you can see all this, okay? So on this, I would lock certain things so that they don't move, because as a teacher and as a student, the worst thing you want to happen is when you come up to the board and you go to touch something, or you're moving one thing and something else moves, okay? One, it kind of takes your breath away for a second, and the second thing, mostly for the kids, they'll get embarrassed if things move that aren't supposed to move just because they're nervous being up here to begin with, okay? So this is where the lock feature comes into play. We type movies versus the Elizabethan Theater. You see my little symbol here? I don't have my BFF there. It's a lock, okay? So I'm actually gonna unlock it, and then my BFF comes. So if I'm a kid and I come up here and I've never done this before, and I'm like, what am I supposed to do? Can you see how that just moves like that? Okay. Like I said before, one could be very shocking. Then as a teacher, when you're up here and you're trying to go over something, stuff just starts going all over the board. You're like, what the hell? Okay. So instead of distracting, because as you see how I just moved that? That's why lock comes into play. So I'm gonna tap on this, I'm gonna go to my BFF, I'm gonna choose lock, and then I'm gonna decide here which one do I pick. If a kid is never gonna use move it like a title, okay, just pick lock. I'm gonna lock in place. So then that way I can touch this all day long and it's never gonna move, okay? If I want them to move, let's say I want this guy, I'm gonna change this, and I'm gonna have him only move it vertical, okay? I can move it, but I sure can't go horizontal, okay? So I'm actually kind of guiding the kid and guiding yourself so you know which way to go, okay? Because we've all been up there talking and then you lose your train of thought. Like, oh, what was I? Okay. All right, so, and then allow move. This is nice. What's nice about that feature is that the kid can move it wherever they want. They can't resize it. So that comes into play where maybe it's a map and they have to put a particular object in a certain area, like a limited area you want to fit. You do lock but allow move so they can't resize it. Okay? All right. So those are some of the features of the lock. Okay? Because the other thing is, and let me just draw this real quick. All right. The other thing is that when a kid comes up here and taps on it, he sees this and he sees that. Naturally, the kid's going to want to grab that green circle. He's not going to move it. He's going to rotate it. Okay? Or he's going to grab this gray one. And he's just going to make it bigger, and that's going to, like, bother them. So that's why you want to use the lock feature as well. Allow move. Okay? So then that way it's locked, but they can't move it. Okay, so if you noticed, I just created a table here, and some of you may be thinking, that's kind of cool, I think I can use that. Okay? It's a table, I have hidden objects underneath it. Okay? So here, this is a quick sorting. Previews. Do we get previews, or did they get previews when they went to the theater back in the?
No.
Okay. So no. Alright. We do when we go to movies today. Were there any props? You have props at the movie cinema today? Or you have limited props here? So basically, you can create a table and you can hide information underneath it. And the kids can reveal it just by tapping on it. Okay? The other thing that I use this for is that when I created groups, I'd have like group one, group two, group three, and as a group finished, I would hide that number so I knew that that from group seven. Okay, or the kid would come up and tap on it and say, hey, we're done. Okay? All right, so that's part of your lock feature. Go back here. All right, so that covers your whole locking phase here. Let me unlock that. Okay. Another feature that the VFF does is, let's say you want to have a word or an image and you want to make it a hyperlink. You want it to link out to maybe a Word document. You want to link it to another page. You want to link it to a video. Using your VFF tool, you can say link to a tool, and I'm going to back up there. You can link this to a pin tool, to an eraser, or to a certain selection, not outside of the application. That is link. I jumped ahead on that one. So let's say I want to say link to a tool, and let's say I want the pin tool to pop up here. Okay? So now when a kid taps on it, my pin tool becomes active. And like that. So that's going to help guide them. All right? Okay, I'm in my pin tool. Gonna do that. Alright. So some other features you have is that you can flip, you can order. And this is where, remember the sheet of paper example that I showed? That's where if you need to hide things or move things up from a different order, you can do that. Okay? So let's do this. We're going to use this ordering tool here. So on your notebook, empty page, I want you to go to your gallery. Okay? I want you to do a search. Up here for cards. Okay? So you're going to go to your gallery. You have a blank page. You're going to type right here cards, like deck of cards. Okay? Deck of cards. Everybody find it?
Yes.
Okay. Let me give you a second. Okay.
They gave me related folders and then search.
Right. Okay, so when you search for cards, you get related folders, you get two folders, deck of cards, right?
Right.
Tap on related folder, and you're going to open it up, and it's going to give you cards, right? Just like playing cards. I want you to pull out the Ace of Hearts. Okay, so how do you do that? You can tap and drag. So tap on the card, drag it to the stage, okay? So we're going to drag the Ace of Hearts, the Two of Spades.
Oh, cards. I said cards.
Cards.
Cards, like a deck of cards.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. So I want you to grab an ace, a two, a three, and a four. It doesn't matter what if it's a club, a diamond, or anything like that. I just need you to get four cards that have ace, two, three, four on them. Okay.
I'm ready.
All right. So what I want you to do here is by using your BFF and using your ordering options, okay? So my BFF order I want you to put these cards in order. So we have ace, and then I have the two and the three. Do you see how they're coming in not even? I want them to lay on top of one another. So my ace is on the bottom, my two, my three, and then my four. Okay? I want you to order them. So how do you do that? My ace is on the bottom. So I want to make sure that my ace is always on the bottom. Okay? So I did that by, okay, I did that by making sure that all my other three cards, when I slide it over the ace, that they're on top, okay? My two goes behind, right? So I'm going to go to my order, and I'm going to bring forward. So now my two lays there. My three, and then my four. So try to do that. Try to make them lay as if I actually had a deck of cards laid out and they're laying on top of one another.
What's my selection?
Okay, anybody having trouble with that?
No trouble.
No trouble.
I just got a question.
Yeah.
I can look at all, but I've got it laid up.
It's because you pulled it out in the right order, like, to whereas you pulled out your ace first, so your ace is going to sit, and then you pulled out your two, and then you pulled out your three, and then you pulled out your four.
Okay.
To whereas I ended up pulling out my ace last. Yeah, so I got a bruise.
Yeah, because I did the four, it wouldn't let me put it on the front. It kept on dipping it back behind my third.
Oh, okay. Next time.
I pulled it out, but it was like, it won't let me move it. It was like, because I took it on.
So I was going to ask, what was the purpose of it?
Go back and pull it out. Away.
So where you find it at?
Click the
BFF tool.
Click the card and then the little arrow.
Click on it.
Okay. So what is the difference between bring forward and bring to front?
Bring it forward might only move it up like one layer.
Correct. Bring it to the front, it's going to take it to the top layer, okay? And for the opposite, send back and send backwards. Backwards is going to take it to the very bottom layer, okay? So this is important because as you begin to create lessons, you're going to use that ordering to make things layer right so you can make it appear properly, okay? All right. So that's part of your BFF, okay? I'm going to jump over here to the pins because I've been playing with the pins and you're probably kind of wondering, you know, what's all on me there, okay? So I'm going to go through here and the gentleman who can't write real well.
Carol.
Mr.
Carol.
Can I get you to come? Harold?
Carol.
Carol.
Mr. Carol.
Come here.
If I wanted to,
let's see this right.
Is there anything I can push to make it whether even, or do I have to just try and make it even as possible?
Oh, that's okay. So the question was, how can I make these? How can I make these cards? You want to be level, right? All right. So I'm going to do something called a marquee select. So I make sure that I'm an arrow.
Mr. Carroll.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And then I'm just gonna like take my mouse, start in the corner, and I'm going to select all of these just by dragging across and dropping down. And it's kind of frozen there for a second. Right? So then once I get them lined up, see if it's in under alignment here. What did they move to in 17? There's an alignment here. View alignment, and then I can get them to line up. Here's your show alignment, or if I want them to snap to a guide. So basically, this is going to give you like guides to get everything to line up. Okay? So I'm going to expose them all, and I'm going to make them blue. Okay? So now, do you see how I slide this across? Do you see how my blue lines line up? So I can line them up. So where they're all even. How's that? Does that work for you?
Okay. Yes, that works.
So since we have the alignment on and I have snap, like when an object gets close to an area.
There you go.
Sports center.
That's enough.
Mr. Saunders, why is my opinion saying 10%? So get me out of here.
Alright, so while I'm plugging this in, I'm going to have my friend up here. He's actually going to help me explain all of the writing tools. Okay? So I'm going to have you tap on the pen for me. Okay? And then I want you to pick a color.
Pick the color. You might not. Yeah, Miss Carol said.
Whatever you want to do, Miss Carol.
All right. Okay.
All right. So, what was the handwriting?
As I heard y'all say, y'all were helping him, and that's great. He can pick a color from the bottom, or he can pick a color up here from the top. Okay. So, you got your color?
Yeah, I got mine.
Alright. I want you to print your name.
Print.
That's
your cool. You know how to spell that, right?
Alright.
Print.
Okay, print.
Right.
Okay, so
his knuckle was right with
him. Wait, my knuckle was right. Can I?
Yeah. So if you want to erase, tap the eraser. And erase. Okay. So when you go to write with a pen, whether you write with a pen or you write with your finger, you want to be sure that nothing else is touching the board whatsoever. Okay? So, better. So then what you can do here is that you have to be an arrow. Okay, now tap on your name. There you go. Okay, now tap on your BFF.
BFF.
Does it recognize it?
This is the first day.
Okay. All right. All right. Now it's your Toby. So it's getting better. You can then make it smaller and resize it.
So my question is this now. What if I'm doing something like this?
Yeah, do your math up there. Listen to
this. Like this.
Oh, that's great.
Actually, you separate the
what you need to do is pick
it up.
Move it around from the board. So
okay.
Like you did the four. Pick it up. Do
yeah,
the
Yeah, that's gray space.
Now, I'm writing, but usually I'm writing fast in this, so I
just... You have to slow down.
Okay, so I can click on this.
Let me get you a new sheet of paper. Let's try that.
Let's try that.
And I'm gonna change the view here.
Wide space.
View screen. Yeah, right. So math and science normally do page width. ELA does the length.
There it is. Bring it away now. Bring it away.
Okay. So now.
Equals.
Go be an arrow.
Well, it's an expression.
Yeah. So now go be an arrow.
Not an equation.
An arrow.
Yeah.
An arrow.
I
now tap on a little BFF. Do you recognize it?
We almost there.
We're almost there.
We're almost there. It's a little above my grade level right here. But I would just leave it as this, because this I would leave it as that.
Okay. Because you can recognize it, and I'll show you the hand. There's also a pen called the handwriting tool that will automatically change it for you. So even if he converts it, then you can do tap twice. Then you can highlight what you want, and then you can correct.
Okay.
By like bringing up your keyboard, so like what is it?
That's
supposed to. If I continue to do this,
you have to pick it up just a little. And that is just practice. That is just practicing. But I want you to try this pen. Yeah. I want you to try this pen for a second. We're going to pick your
What size? What is it? Yeah, normally when I write on a small board, it always skips like that.
Okay. So, what I'm showing him, there you go. Now wait for it. Keep writing, okay. So I had him use a handwriting pen. And within a matter of 3 seconds, it recognizes what he wrote and it'll automatically convert to text.
So you layered it, and so your M is up under your ATH.
Let's not be that.
So then he could actually come here and move it over.
That'll work.
Cool.
Can you demonstrate the tool that Jim Charleston has in?
Yes. Okay, so. Jacob came right here. Jacoby came here and he picked the text pen. So the text pen will convert anything to text in a matter of 3 seconds.
Okay.
It'll ask you to confirm it to make sure that it's right.
What's the magic?
Hold on, let's get that hand.
So the straight pen, you just write. Okay? The calligraphy pen, now write
calligraphy.
Jacoby, write your name. Okay?
Jacoby.
Now, the calligraphy pen is super cool because kids say they can read that if they're in the back of the classroom a whole lot easier than they can with the normal pens. Okay? So when I write, I like to write in the calligraphy pen. Just because it makes it easier, and for you, the way you write, and your speed, the calligraphy pen is probably going to be the best option for you.
So what does it do?
So I want to
basically what it does is like it knows what I'm writing,
but it makes it look cleaner too.
Okay. It's a type of a font. It's thin in some areas and thicker in another, just like Old English.
Okay.
It's a calligraphy pen, but you're not actually having to write that.
Precise.
Yes. Right. And for him, that works really well. And you can see it better in the back than you could see what when he wrote before.
Okay. Happy now.
That works.
Yeah, it is.
I'm not done. Okay, so we also have a crayon pen. Crayon pen is more for fun.
You're trying to embarrass.
Okay. No. So the crayon pen actually writes in crayon. Okay. So you can come up here and you can write in crayon, and it gives multiple colors for you. Okay. You can draw images. Okay.
I noticed I auto-corrected the spacing as well. So if I was circling around, I made sure that it was enough to meet the whole.
Absolutely. Right. Okay. So then you have a highlighter. So the highlighter is basically what it is. You pick your color. You can do fat or you can do thin. And then he can just highlight over information. Okay. And you can utilize that when we talk about maybe you bring something up that's on a PDF and you want to highlight it or on your document camera, okay? All right. So the text pen, I'm going to go back over this, write dog. Okay. So he's using the text pen.
You're not dog.
Do you see how it confirms it says yes or no? If he taps on the green, then we're good, okay? Now, let's say you want to write the word,
cat.
Yeah. Write the word cat.
Can I practice?
Miss Bella?
Yeah.
Can I practice?
You want to play?
Yes, I have a handwriting too. I'm just going to see it. Yeah.
Let's do that. Okay. It even picked that up. Okay.
How about
so let's say, but let's say you want to drop the X. Come over here. Draw a line through it. Undo. Just draw a line through it. It removes it. Okay. So the text pen allows you to edit any word that you want. Okay. If he wants to add it back, or let's say he wants to spell cats with a K, draw a line straight down, and it gives you a space.
Or just say okay. Spell this.
It's gonna say, okay. You say yes, and then,
what's the no?
Okay, so then fix it.
So it don't do spelling errors.
It erases it all. And you write it over. Or you can just add it.
Just add it in.
Okay? So basically, if you have a word and you need to get rid of a word, you draw a line through it. If you need to add a space in between the word to add a letter, you draw a line in between the words. Okay? Then, if you want to.
Class what?
Then if you want to add a word, I can add it here and I'll
that's why
that's what it goes to.
Okay. So here's okay, how about this? Here, you write write the dog jumped over the fence.
No, this is this pen. I had a grammatical mistake.
Right. Okay, so with the text pen, you have to wait for it to convert. So she said, okay, she wants to type the word jump. So I want you to just draw a line through and it gets rid of it. Now, do a carrot.
A carrot?
A carrot. Like an arrow. Now write jump.
Lyman's turn.
You like that?
How does that translate to a computer? That's only a smart board?
It's only for the board.
Yeah, gotcha.
Okay. Now you do a space. How do you do a space?
Do this one too.
You can draw.
Oh, just though.
So here we need to get rid of that, right?
Uh-huh.
So just draw a line to the OF. Okay, and then we need a space, so draw a line straight down.
The dog jumped the fence.
And now we need over. Okay. So we're gonna do a carrot. There you go. And then we can write over. Okay, and then confirm. Okay. The dog. Get that out. And if you notice, as she's writing, it's doing predictive text and it's helping you spell it out. Okay?
No, ma'am.